Hi guys, TotallyDubbed here, and today I'm doing a video review on the AKG Y500 Wireless. Now, if you've looked up the Y50s in the past, you probably would have come across my video. If you haven't, well, you've maybe saved yourself some time, I'm not sure. But nevertheless, in the video, I basically covered the wired variant of the Y50. Now, since then, the Y50 had the Y50BT, which is a Bluetooth variant, and now it's the Y500. That extra zero makes it all new and special. Now, the headphones themselves are wireless on-ear headphones that connect over Bluetooth and, of course, can be connected via wired connection as well. They can be found for £129 in the UK. Links will be down in the description below in case you're interested. And also in the description, you'll find my list of alternatives that you might want to consider. And I'll be alluding to them in this video. Now in the box, it's pretty simple. You've got the headphones themselves, user manual, and then you've got a set of cables, one for charging and actual cables in order for you to use them. As you can see, I've never used them before because I haven't had to, but one thing to note is that the connector, the interconnect, is a 2.5mm to 3.5mm cable, so do bear that in mind. It's not 3.5 to 3.5mm. Now the case is a nice sort of design, and it's pretty portable, so no complaints there. It's not a hard shell carrying case, so just worth bearing in mind. As you can see, it's pretty soft. Now, in terms of the headphones themselves, let's go into the build quality and design. Now, it's pretty much retained the same sort of design and build quality of the original Y50s. That can be a little bit hit and miss because the Y50s over time had a sort of problem that I read on numerous Amazon reviews where the hinge would break. Now, I can't really say after owning them for basically 1 to 2 weeks how this is going to fare after, I don't know, a year of usage, but all I can say is that the design itself looks very similar to the Y50s. Now the headphones themselves have got an adjustable headband, as you might expect. Very limited padding at the top, however it's rubberized, meaning it's very easy to clean, which is nice to see. The headphones completely fold inwards, as you can see over here, and also the drivers rotate or swivel by 90 degrees, meaning that you can store them in a variety of ways. I like that fact, and they're very much truly portable. They're very much lightweight as well. You're not going to really feel them on your head, and also if you have them around your neck when they're not in use. In terms of design, they've gone kind of to the drawing board. It looks very much more of a professional product rather than having that massive AKG logo slapped on like these really weird colors. I think what AKG have done over here brought it to more of like a professional line, and I quite like that. It still remains fun but yet professional. So you've got a chamfered edge around the side making it look nice. It's still available in a variety of colors, and it is still very much an on-ear headphone, which I'll get into in just a bit. So as far as build quality and design goes, I've got no complaints. Now in terms of ports, now I'm a little bit disappointed. First of all, that 2.5mm jack can be a little bit of a pain, but I can understand why a lot of manufacturers do it. There is a play pause button, volume up and down. Now, if you hold the button up or down, it will also skip or previous in terms of the song that you're listening to. What I found is that that took 2 seconds to activate, which seems fine, but when you're actually using on a daily basis, let's say you're like me and you've got a shuffle on and you just want to skip through different songs, that, you know, skipping through 5 different songs is 10 seconds, and that's more time than you'd normally want to spend when you're skipping songs. Moving on from that, on the other side, you've got an on and off button, which also toggles on the Bluetooth, which you can enable pairing mode. Then you've got a micro USB port, which at £130, I would have expected maybe USB-C, specifically coming from AKG, but nevertheless, that's not included. Then you've got a button over here with the ambient mode. Now the ambient mode, in all honesty, all it does is turns off the headphones, essentially, really quickly so you can hear your surroundings. It doesn't amplify the surroundings around you, which is a bit of a pain because I would have preferred to amplify that your surroundings so you can hear them a little bit better. Nevertheless, that button does that. Now, the biggest complaint I've got about these buttons is the fact that when you switch them on or you press this ambient aware button, it gives off a really loud audio cue, like it's a really loud beep that you can hear. And it's very hard to ignore, and to the point that it actually hurts my ears when that happens. And I really can't stress that enough. I really hate that. I don't know why AKG have done this. Potentially they'll bring out a firmware update to reduce that audio cue noise. And no, it didn't really depend on the volume of the actual headphones or what they were set at. Neither with my phone. It just was really loud audio cues. I have no idea why that's the case. But nevertheless, thought to mention it. Now, going on to the on-ear design. Now, this thing, I mean, all honesty, I have never understood why people really love on-ear designs, but nevertheless, there are people out there, you crazy odd people, but nevertheless, the on-ear design is comfortable. The pads themselves are really well padded, but given their on-ear design, you can expect them to sit on your ears. Now, this has two disadvantages, or three potentially. First of all, in terms of comfort, if you wear glasses, you're going to find these uncomfortable. Over a period of time, and I have a medium-sized head, I would say, for a male, I found these to be uncomfortable. Moving on from that, you've got isolation, which is isolation from the outside world. Over here, again, the isolation of on-ears, no matter what company makes on-ears, will always be poorer than in-ears and over-the-ears, or noise-cancelling in-ears or over-the-ears. So in this case, your on-ear design is really going to limit you in terms of isolation and also gives you a bit of leakage. In other words, if you're listening to these headphones at, let's say, 80% volume, which is plenty loud, what you're going to notice is that your commuter who's sitting next to you is going to be able to hear your music because of that on-ear design. Then finally, we've got, in terms of the actual use case of it, in terms of how they're going to sit on your head, what I found is that if I were going on a jog, or if I were to move my head and bop my head back and forth, like listening to an old school, I don't know, an old school R&B song, what I found is these slowly slipped off my head, specifically when it's really hot and your ears get sweaty or your head gets sweaty, these are just going to fall straight off, which really does make me think, why would anyone want on-ears? Anyway, that's my little rant about on-ears, but also due to the design of the headphones, I have to comment on that. It's not something I can kind of ignore. But, you know, these things are subjective as such. So bear in mind that I've heard over 300 different headphones and earphones and reviewed them and potentially demoed over 500 or so. So I'm just giving you my own experience from my own unbiased experience. Now let's move on to the sound quality. Now, the biggest thing which really got me about this was the fact that this was limited to Bluetooth SBC codec only. That, for people who don't know, is the lowest quality Bluetooth codec you can get on a Bluetooth device. It's not using AAC, APTX or LDAC or anything else you can think of. SBC is what it's limited to. And before I move on to sound quality, and before I do forget, battery life has been improved over the Y50BT. It's now 33 hours. Your mileage may vary. All I can say is that it did last a very long time when on my commutes, and I didn't have to recharge them. So I just thought just to point that out as we're moving on to Bluetooth. Now, in terms of sound quality goes, it is very much the same case as the Y50s. They've very much got the same sort of sound signature. If you love the Y50s for some odd reason, or you read some reviews that were paid and biased, then you'll absolutely love the Y50s. In this case, I'm comparing these to what you can currently find on the market, be it over-ears, in-ears, even on ears. Now, first of all, let's talk about the sub bass. The sub bass is pretty much non-existent. You don't get that really long bass rumble. The mid bass is present and it is a little bit subdued, but that said, it's very controlled and very nice. I would say the best aspect of these headphones are its mid bass response. AKG have nailed that. In terms of the mid-range is hit and miss. You've got a decent upper mid reproduction where you've got the vocals that come out pretty well, but then you've got a recessed mid-range. It is to be kind of expected at this price range. You don't expect £150 Bluetooth headphones to really be amazing in that respect, in that sort of frequency, but it's worth bearing in mind. The highs, they're rolled off, they're kind of chopped off, and you don't really get that lovely sparkle that you'd really want. Now, the thing which really concerned me and really compared to, let's say, the Lindy BNX-60s or the BNX-100s or a variety of different over-the-ear or in-ears that you can find was its soundstage. The soundstage is very much closed. And no, it's not purely due to driver size, and you know, some people will be like, the bigger the driver, the better the soundstage, but that's not always the case. What I found is the soundstage was pretty closed, pretty narrow sounding, pretty claustrophobic. Instrument separation was really good, and the imaging and tonality of it sounded pretty poor, to say the least. So that's really my thoughts of the sound quality. It really wasn't impressive. For £129, you can do far better. In fact, you can spend £80 and get way better Bluetooth headphones. They just won't be on ear, and they'll have APTX codecs. So that pretty much leads me on to my verdict. What do I think about these headphones? Well, in all honesty, I just think that they're a complete waste of money, just like the Y50s were. But for some reason, I got heavily flamed on YouTube for saying that. But I'm still gonna say it. I don't think these products are good. I don't know why people would buy them. And in all honesty, given that they're design, I just don't think you're gonna be, you could do a lot better for the money that you're spending, specifically £130. So there we go, guys. Hopefully you've enjoyed this unbiased, unpaid, independent review, as always. If you do, make sure you give it a like, subscribe if you wanna see more honest content, favorite and share if you wanna spread the love, and let me know in the comments below what you think of these headphones. All right, guys, totally dubbed out. Take care, and bye-bye.